Hi folks, welcome back. Hope you're all keeping well. So today we're going to do something a little bit different, which is rather than doing a brand new reaction to a song I've never heard before, we're going to listen to a song I do know that I've heard before, which is Don't Dream It's Over by Crowded House. So this is going to be more of a review. I'm going to do it in the same sort of manner that I normally do my reactions, which I'll play it. I'll maybe stop. This is unscripted, so I'll maybe just stop it occasionally, talk about some things that occur to me. Just see how it goes. We'll play it by ear. It's a song that I've sort of known and loved for a long time. My dad is pretty big fan of Crowded House and Split Enz. So we grew up hearing the songs fairly regularly as kids, you know, on the hi-fi. It's a lovely song. And I got, as part of my poll on Patreon for May, I had listed some bands there and asked people to vote whatever bands they wanted me to talk about with a song that I've already heard. So I've selected Don't Dream It's Over, as Crowded House was one of the top three that month. So a little bit of background on this song before we get going. According to Wikipedia, it was recorded for the self-titled debut studio album of Crowded House in 1986. It was composed and written by frontman Neil Finn. And yeah, it's the fourth single from the album. It's in here that Don't Dream It's Over became the band's biggest international hit, reaching number two on the Billboard Hot 100 in the United States in April 1987. There's quite a bit of other info on there talking about how it was prominently featured in the 1994 miniseries adaptation of Stephen King's novel The Stand, and it's saying here that it's been covered by different artists including Paul Young, Sixpence None the Richer, who I've heard of, but I don't know if I've heard them or not, and another New Zealand artist, Stan Walker. Just a quick disclaimer here as well, so I will be pausing as I go along, so if you haven't heard this song before, make sure you go and listen to it before we get started here. Okay, so I think without further ado, we should really get going, shouldn't we? Beautiful. It just makes me smile so much, and it's so sad sounding, you know, I don't know why. The beautiful groove, lovely little bass line that runs us in. The groove locked in between the drummer and the bass, despite the sort of, you know, it's not heavy in any way. It's sort of light and airy, but there's a real depth to the song. So yeah, beautiful tightness coming together with the bass and the drums on that. Check out the guitar tone at the very start, you know, really crystal clear electric guitar, you know, pretty sure they would be single coils. I don't know if it's a Strat or a Tele or something like that that he's playing. Could be neither. But beautifully crystal clear tone on a guitar with lots of reverb. The rhythm itself, you know, be a da 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 da. Even the strumming of the guitar is incredibly groovy and rhythmic. You know, you're not even just, if you listen carefully, it's not even just da-dum, bum-ba-dum. You can hear sort of, there's sort of much softer ricks. There's more of a groove coming out there, but it's really, really low, really dynamic strumming of the guitar. I'm not going to focus on the lyrics. You know, the lyrics, get the lyrics sheet up and read them through. It's very poetic, beautiful words, lovely melody, lovely chords. We're in the key of E flat. We're actually starting with E flat sus 2. So you've got an E flat chord, but rather than the G in the middle, we've got an F. So already we've got a little bit of dissonance. The F and the E flat are sort of clashing. Okay, and then we move into it's a B flat minor chord with an over an E flat. So we get the pedal note on the bottom, which I guess if he's on the guitar and he's playing that, he's probably using a capo maybe, because you know, E flat's not the typical chord. You can play E flat on the guitar, but it's probably probably playing something like a C maybe, with a capo, I would imagine, because if you put that up, then you could play the open strings more than, you know, you can't really do that on an E flat. With B flat, we can with a G anyway. Sorry. Okay. So so basically that could help with that sort of pedal note kind of thing going on there. You know, you can hear the voicings on top of that are changing though. So yeah. So E flat sus 2. Then we've got B flat minor over the top of that, and then it changes briefly to B flat minor 7. So that's the A flat at the top there now. Back again. The sus. So that's when the melody comes in. Move to C minor. The last note of the phrase there, which the words are, there's freedom within. So as he holds within, it's a D, comes over the C minor. So that's actually another sus 2 chord there. So there's a lot of suspensions in this song, and I think that is partly contributes to this sort of sense of melancholy, because although we've got major chords, minor chords, once you start putting those sort of dissonant notes in there subtly, I don't know, it just gives it a touch of sort of extra depth and magic, you know. So yeah, E flat sus 2 at the start, C minor, now we go to A flat. We've also that tied note from the melody again. D doesn't belong to A flat major, you know, it would be D flat. So we've got, doesn't sound as obvious out in the song because it's his vocal on top of that, but yeah, again, more clashes. Down to G. That's a cadence, so the G would point us back normally to C minor, but goes back to E flat. Lovely, lovely piece of writing. All right, so let's take all that back in again. Lovely delay on the guitar too. Bass. Oh, I listen to the drum sound. Boom, boom. Lots of reverb on the toms. Rim shot on the snare. Groove. There's a battle ahead. Many battles. It's also a synth pad. I think it's that note. There's like a drone there. There's a battle ahead. Many battles are lost. Here, the way the bass is finding lots of space in there too. There's a battle ahead. Many battles are lost. Not getting in the way of the vocal. The end of the road while you're traveling with me. Chorus, the vocals, the falsetto. Ambient textures there on the left. You see the way the drums don't have to do anything? The rhythm's all, that's not all, but so much of it's coming from, presumably it's Neil, isn't it? You know, because he's a guitarist. So, down, bat, down, bum. So much groove from the guitar. If the drums were trying to do too much, it would get in the way, wouldn't it? Really straightforward drumming, but all feel. Let's go on, next verse. Now Harmonics and a guitar, boom. Bit of a whammy, possibly Bigsby. Lovely effects on the guitar there, rakes, you know, strumming the guitar, rather than going down, strumming from the top down, so you're starting with the highest notes coming to the bottom, and then it sounds more like whammy, you know, vibrato on the guitar. I guess you could be holding the guitar and wrestling it. It's more likely to be a whammy bar or a Bigsby. Effects. Hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in, they come to build a wall between us. We know they won't win. Hammond organ. That's just really beautiful playing on the organ there. Do you notice how much the notes overlap one another? So although we've got a melody on that, you know, there's notes being sustained, pivot notes and overlapping. That's so Baroque in style, like Bach. Whenever you play Bach on the piano, you know, because you wouldn't use the sustain pedal the same way that there's no sustain pedal on an organ, that if you want notes to sustain, you really got to do it with your fingers and hold them. But it's very, very cleverly worked out that, because, you know, it's one thing to come up with a melody like that to move around, but to choose this note is going to, this is going to be held over the bar, this one's going to be held over the bar, this one's going to run into this one, those notes all have to be perfectly chosen so that they add and they contribute and they work in that chord that's coming up, you know what I mean? So it's all very very well crafted out as to what notes are chosen to sustain. If you listen very closely again, you'll hear that. I'm sure you've heard it before anyway, but really focus on that this time. Top one's still ringing out. Bottom one ringing out. Middle one. Big snare now. Leslie on the organ. Let's just take all that again. So much happens in there. A lot of build up. Back down. Build. Okay, let's go back a little bit further. I find it interesting that, you know, that's really a guitar solo, and it's so untypical of a guitarist to take a solo part and again focus on rhythm, you know. I mean, there's melodic content there in what's happening, da 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 da. But the first run that goes up, it's more chordal, more harmonic, more strummed, very rhythmic. Transposition there. Now I'm walking again to the beat of a drum, and I'm counting the steps to the door of your heart. Those little spaces are filled with something different every time. Do you also hear it's like wooden blocks and stuff going on there on the left this time? Now I'm walking. Forget this time we've got a full beat in the snare, no? Big sound. Only shadows ahead, barely bass guitar different this time, so not letting down, but we got bum 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 bum. Eighth notes. Quavers. And I'm counting the steps to the door of your heart. Only shadows ahead, barely clearing the roof. Get to know the feeling of liberation and release. Hey now, oh, hey now, don't dream. I forgot about that. It's been so long since I've listened to that. Listen to the chords there, and they're not the same root notes. Get to know the feeling of liberation and release. Hey now, hey now, don't dream. It's all. And back, hey back now, to normal. Hey now, that's just so beautiful. The world comes in, they come to build a wall between us. No, they won't win. On to the right cymbal. Beautiful bass player. Snare roll is that's a sort of throwback to something we had earlier on there, coming into the last verse, wasn't it? Bit of bell work there, lovely. Fade out. Yeah. Okay, it's just a really beautiful song. I want to go back and say one thing. There is another little thing that occurred to me years ago when I first heard this song, was the way the outro organ solo comes in. You notice it sort of comes in halfway through a phrase. So I find it there. Okay, so there. It's interesting to me that it starts at that point, because it doesn't resolve the end of the chorus and then go into it. It's those little sort of choice cuts that keep things within a fairly predictable, dare I say, predictable structure in terms of songwriting. You know, it's not overly complex, not prog by any means. Sure, it's not. So within this kind of style, it's very easy to get into predictability and so on. So I think that's a clever way of being able to keep the song really fresh and make the listener sort of keep the listener on their toes, the same way as would have sounded whenever the chorus came in and they dropped the change, the sort of root notes, the harmony changed on that. We're still using the same sort of patterns and motifs, but just by, let's change that this time, let's change that. Okay, so rather than letting that bar run through to the end, or that phrase run through to the end, start the outro slightly early, you know, so it's not using new music and going, right, let's have this section in here, or do like weird time signatures or anything like that. It's just very subtle things within sort of almost like a pop sort of sentiment. Oh, we've changed now. What's this, you know? The band sort of jam on out there, really, you know? At least that's the feeling it gets. I don't know whether it was recorded you know, with the drummer, the bass, it's sort of like a live band, or if it was all tracked individually. You know, maybe some of you guys that know that information, get that down in the comments, you know, fill in. This is just my thoughts on listening to it as a piece of music, you know, so I'm sure there's plenty of things that I've missed, and you let us know. What else do you really love by Crowded House? Oh, I should mention, if you don't know the guitarist, Matthias Asato, he does a really, really beautiful electric guitar cover of this song. It's just him on his own. There's no band, nothing. I'll maybe throw a quick clip of that just coming in here after we talk. But definitely head over and check his. He's got a really good version of this song. So yeah, like I say, fill me in. More info about the song, things you love about it, and you know, any other Crowded House songs that you know that mean something to you, or you know, any hidden gems. anything you can think of, you know. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Have a look through the channel. I do lots of different sort of breakdowns, mostly on first-time listens. But yeah, I've done this for Grace by Jeff Buckley. I did one of these kind of videos. I think I did it with another Opeth song as well. Was it Benighted? So yeah, I'm going to be doing a few more of these. The other two songs that are going to be on the Maypole will be Death on Two Legs by Queen and Bleak by Opeth. So keep an eye out for those videos. They'll be coming soon as well. So thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.